Hi, Aquarius. It is me, Alex, and I am here to bring you your weekly tarot reading. I hope you guys are doing well. Let's see what God, Angels, Universe has for you, Aquarius. Moon. Work. Knight of Swords. Six of Swords. Four of Swords. Queen of Pentacles. Queen of Pentacles. In your feelings, in your emotions. Oh. I feel like there's a Capricorn. A Capricorn who you are It's like you could have met somebody, you're getting to know somebody, you're very attracted to this person. There she is, Queen of Pentacles. You got the Queen of Wands, Queen of Pentacles. There you are, Aquarius, with the Fool. I read that as Aquarius versus Aries. Seven of Pentacles, King of the Emperor, Justice. Oh, I'm hearing come to Jesus. Okay. This feels like a talk. It feels like you met somebody. You've known them for a while. Maybe since June or July of whatever year. That's weird. But you met them in June or July of one year. And I feel like you feel like maybe you're in the dark about a situation, maybe how they feel. No cups on the table. Not one cup here on the table. So I feel like you're trying to figure out if somebody's feelings have changed for you, if somebody has feelings for you. I feel like that's the focus of your attention right now. And it's almost like, well, tell me, yeah, because you're trying to figure out, should I keep trying? Should I stick around or should I just kind of move on? With the Seven of Pentacles, that's waiting, overanalyzing, waiting for something to ripen, waiting for something to mature. And that Emperor card is the whole truth, the full truth, and nothing but the truth. So help you, God, right? With that Four of Swords, yeah, I feel like some of you guys could be in your head, in your emotions, and you're trying to figure out what the is going on. Yeah, look, you're waiting. Ew, some of you guys could be afraid that, and I put afraid in quotes because some of y'all just may not give a good damn, right? But I feel like, yeah, it's either you're waiting to have a conversation with this person about like the state of your relationship. Arguing. Yeah, look at more waiting, more immaturity. Four swords on four swords. I'm hearing you don't know how to approach this person. Queen of Pentacles again. Have the Queen of Pentacles here three times. I feel like this is somebody who's incredibly important to you. Very honest, very upfront, very reliable. And I also kind of feel like this person's pattern might have changed and you're trying to figure out, well, what happened. I feel like you will hear the truth. This person will tell you the truth. The Queen of Pentacles is honest, right? Male or female. Energy is genderless, so take it as it resonates. I also feel like whomever this is, they hit the spot, right? As in they're reliable, like they're good for you. They make you laugh. You know, you can always call and talk to them. They're always there. But it kind of feels like with this Five of Wands and the Knight of Swords is just going for it. Maybe you're just going to outright ask them, or yo, Angel said you're avoiding that. I gotcha. That's why I don't read reversals, because I always say to people, angels are going to give me the message no matter what the position of the card. They're giving me the message if this card was in the reverse, right? So it's almost like somebody is wanting to talk, wanting to have a conversation, but feel like maybe it'll cause an argument, or maybe you'll be rejected. Maybe you'll find out that there's somebody else. I do have a three on the table representing a third party, and Lord knows you got enough queens on the table for the end of time. You have four queens on the table with the emperor. So angels just said this person is every woman, right? The Whitney Houston or Chaka Khan, I'm every woman. This, whomever this person is, whether they're male, female, non-binary, doesn't make a difference, but this is your go-to person. Whether, I don't feel like this is romantic though. There is not one cup on the table. Angels are pointing me to Sagittarius and saying this person, you and this person are highly compatible. This could be a friend, a coworker, family member, and you guys could have recently had a disagreement, and you're hoping that that disagreement doesn't tear you guys apart. But I feel like maybe from your side, or could be your person's side, Aquarius, somebody is afraid to maybe bring this up or have this conversation for fear that, yeah, it may cause an argument. It may cause a breakup. You know, somebody is going to walk away, leave you behind. Maybe you have to leave them behind. I picked up the Queen of Pentacles because I wanted to show the double queens and the justice. I feel like you guys will eventually wind up on the same page. Maybe they want to come out of the friend zone. You want to come out of the friend zone. But I feel like in the end, you guys are going to agree. Well, no, let's just keep things as is. And again, I point your direction to the fact that there is not one cup on the table. And it's ironic because the moon card, which is Pisces and also Cancer for me as a reader, with this moon card, it's like somebody's got secret feelings or secret emotions. They're very passionate. They're very attracted to you. But I feel like they could be waiting for you to make a move as well. They could be waiting for you to express your feelings. Maybe you don't have any feelings for this person. You just want to keep them in the friend zone. Because you may feel like that's what's best for you. Now, with the double four of swords, it's almost like, well, the friend zone is good because we don't get into any arguments. We don't, you know, don't have bullshit expectations. And I feel, again, that's your decision. Four of swords, four of swords. Four of swords is calling a truce, right? Four of swords is like taking a time out. Like, okay, I need a minute. I need to go take a knee. So you and this person... you may not be on speaking terms, and forgive me because I know all kinds of messages are coming up. Remember, it's a general reading, and what I'm trying to do based on the cards that I'm seeing is give you guys the different scenarios, because I feel like this is probably going to resonate with at least five different types of Aquariuses. Okay. Five different Aquarian situations, angels just said. Angels also just said too, five different, or Aquarius in five different situations with the same person, which says to me, you done been through it all with this person. But at the end of the day, they still wind up being there for you. I have Libra there, which is the justice, which is universal karma. I feel like this person's going to continue to be there for you. Everything was going great. Then you guys had some sort of argument. Now you guys are trying to find your way back to each other while maybe tempering your emotions. You don't want to upset the tide. For you, it's almost like, no, well, let me just kind of give them space and let them, you know, kind of take their time and, you know, float their way back to me naturally. And at the end of the day, they will. Ooh, they will float them their way back to you. As the same person that they've always been. Ah, I like that. New love, a new person has stirred your romantic feelings. Maybe this person, or maybe you, kind of fell off because of new love. They might have floated away because of new love, or you might have floated away because of new love. And whoever your ace boon coon is, your ride or die friend, maybe friends with benefits, they're in an uproar right now. Because it's like, wait, you been Aquarius? And Aquarius is like, well, let's talk. You know what I mean? And you could be telling them, you know, I know you've always been there for me. I know we go back like four flat tires, but I met somebody new. Ooh, ooh. Pay attention to the red flags. The signs are cautioning you. Now, it's ironic that I read this, that this card came up, because what I heard too is that, especially with this moon card, I feel like there's some sort of fear that, you know, maybe this friend, coworker, whomever feels like because you met this new person, you're going to drift away from the friendship. Ooh, this is an unusual reading. Mm-hmm. Angel said, pull five. Let your friends help you. Ask for and accept support from others. See what I'm saying? That friend, that BFF, the one who's been there for you, the one you cried on their shoulder, they cried on your shoulder. I feel like your friendship is being tested. Religious factors. Your love life is influenced by your religious upbringing and spiritual path. Oh, angels are saying your commitment. So if y'all are best friends, y'all known each other for a while, it's almost like that's y'all's religion. That's supposed to stay in place. Ooh. Trust. This situation is calling for you to have faith. Yeah. Let me summarize this with one storyline. It kind of feels like somebody who has been extremely reliable for you, you're waiting on them, but it's taking too long, and you're afraid that this person is drifting off and drifting away. I feel like there was an enormous amount of flexibility in this relationship. This relationship was incredibly solid, beautiful foundation built. Whenever y'all would get into it, you would work it out. Everything would, you know, kind of go back to normal. I feel like in this particular argument or disagreement or whatever the case is, something was said that's making you or your person believe, okay, you know what? I'm done with them. I was going to start shuffling, and Angel said, no, hold, because I feel like whatever this card is, they want you to see. So y'all got into it, and yeah, everybody might have bid their good riddance, like, well, screw you. Well, screw you too. And you felt like whatever this very solid friendship, relationship situation that was on solid ground and was secure for so long, maybe for the first time in a long time, you feel like, oh shit, like it really might be over. And with the Temperance card, it's like, no, let's everybody calm down, right? We've invested too much in this relationship. You go off and do what you need to do, go in and hang out with your boo or be with your boo, or maybe they're saying to you, Aquarius, go ahead and be with your boo. And it's almost like you guys might have agreed to separate, right? That might have been the best decision for now. And I feel like as you guys are apart from each other, you're going to thrive. You're going to grow. You're going to, you know, become more independent. Angels are saying this could have been codependency too. You might have relied on them too heavily. They might have relied on you too heavily. And now the universe is trying to separate you guys so you can grow individually. That's interesting. But in keeping with the first storyline, which is the same storyline, it kind of feels like when you guys agree to disagree and you agree to separate, you agree to take a break, you guys are going to be okay. But angels are also saying too, with this karma card, you will find your way back towards each other. Look at this. Free yourself. It's time to take control. It's time to take back control over your life. That's why Angel said to me, hold this, right? Because I feel like you, and this is going to sound weird, Aquarius, y'all might have been too close. Y'all might have been really close. Whereas maybe the reason why you were both single is because the friendship kept getting in the way. Not because of anything you or your person was doing, you and your best friend was doing, but because your mate, the person you met, didn't understand your relationship. And for some of you guys, yeah, maybe you put your friendship in front of the relationship, and that's why you guys were single for so long. But it feels like there is independence on the horizon for the two of you individually. And I feel like while you guys are independent, that's where love comes in. Because again, no cups, not a one, no mas, right? Look at that. Romance. Yeah, I feel like you guys are separating so you can meet your romantic partner. It's up to you. Let go, boy. No. Yeah, there's the friction and resistance. Wait. Yeah, look at that. Trust. Oh my goodness. Yeah, it just kind of feels like, again, you were, whether it was codependency or just used to, stuck in a comfort zone, and now you're coming out of that comfort zone and you're afraid because you don't have your wings, they're not working right, or your legs, you can't, you know, stand up like a baby calf. This is scary for a lot of you to step outside of your comfort zone and away from whatever this stability was. For some of you guys, you could be moving out. For some of you guys, you could be moving on from a job. So angels are saying military, as in you signed up for the military, you got to go through basic training, and basic training is out and away from your hometown. So it kind of feels like you're coming out of some sort of nest here, Aquarius, and it's scary. But again, the double queen of pentacles, baby, you're going to be okay. I promise you, you're going to be okay. Let's see what Moonology has. I'm reading all of the oracle cards I have on the table. What do we have for Aquarius? Ooh, two cards. Look at that. Don't let pride get in your way. The end of a tough cycle approaches. Y'all see all these ending cards that keep coming up? Look at the bigger picture. Ooh. Yeah, It feels like there's some sort of scary ending, but it is for your own good, Aquarius. And I know how horrible that sounds. I hate when people say it to me. Oh, something is ending, or you're having a tower moment, but it's in your favor. It's like, first of all, I don't give a what's in my favor. I'm caring about the tower moment that I'm experiencing. And with this moon card here, yeah, there's some fear of the unknown. So I have Pisces and Cancer. I have Aries here in the moon position, Capricorn in the moon position, Aquarius sun. I have Gemini in rising or Mercury position, Sag in sun position, Aries in sun position, Capricorn, double Capricorn in the moon position, and Libra in the sun position. I feel like the person that you're dealing with is a Capricorn, and I think I said that in the beginning, or a Capricorn is the catalyst for this change. All right, my lovely Aquarius, I'm going to go ahead and leave it here. If the reading does resonate, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. I love you. Bye.